Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Code with Sunny. In this video I am going to talk about the problem Phoenix and SOX problem D type of code forces global round 14. Okay, so let's try to first understand this problem and we will together find out the best solution of this problem. In this problem there is a person Phoenix that has brought n SOX and is going to be like even also, that is even always. Okay, and each of the SOX is going to denote a color, that is it will have a color CI. And it will also denote either belonging to a left sock or a right sock. Okay, and there is one more offer that you can also say that Phoenix can pay $1 to the sock store to either recolor a sock to any other color, or turn a left sock to a right sock, or turn a right sock to a left sock. Okay, that is paying $1 and doing any one of the operations. Okay, and we need to find what is the minimum cost to make n by 2 matching pairs. Okay. And you can also understand that each sock must be included in exactly one matching pair, and we need to find what will be the minimum cost. Okay, now you can see total number of socks would be like is at most 2 into 10 power 5, n should be even, and L plus R should be exactly equal to n. L is going to denote the number of left sock, and that is the socks for left type, and R is going to denote the number of right socks, and color is going to vary up to, that is every value CI is going to vary up to at most n starting from 1. Okay, and we need to find the minimum cost for Phoenix to make n by 2 matching pairs. Okay, so let us try to understand this problem and find out the best solution with the help of examples. Okay, so let's move further. Okay, suppose we have been given this value, that is this SOX, where L is going to be like 3 and R is going to be like 3. L is going to be like 3, that is first 3 integers which denotes the colors for the left socks, and then followed by the R amount of integers denotes that colors for the right socks. Okay, now you can see we have the left socks as 1, 2 and 3, and we have the right socks as 2, 2, 2. Okay, we need to find the matching pairs. Okay, it means that if some socks is going to like color of some socks is already present in the color of some, that is in the first pair, that is you can also understand that if color 2 is present in left sock, and again a color, again a sock is present which is of type right sock, you can easily see there is a matching pair 2 comma 2. We can just neglect that, that is we have already found one matching pair. And what is the maximum matching pair that we need to find? We need to find n by 2 matching pairs, that is here you can see n is going to be like 6, and we need to find 3 matching pairs. I have already found one matching pair, that is 2 and 2. Now you can see left sock contains 1 and 3, and that is color of type, that is color 1 and color 3, that is of left sock. And another you can see on the case of right sock, I have the color 2 and again a color 2. Okay, now you can see easily see that we need to find n by 2 matching pairs, that is we have already found one matching pair and we need to find 2 matching pairs more. And what are the operations that we can done? You can easily see we can recolor a sock, or turn a left sock into a right sock, or turn a right sock into a left sock. Okay, now you can see the colors are going to be like distinct, that is all the colors in the left sock are going to be like pairwise distinct, and all the colors in the right sock are going to be like pairwise distinct. Now we need to find the minimum cost, that is we need to minimize the cost to find n by 2 matching pairs. You can easily see I can convert this one to any color with the cost equal to 1. So with my choice I can convert this one to this 2, and now after converting this to this value color equal to 2, you can see I have found a matching pair 2 comma 2. Okay, but you can easily see I need cost equal to 1 to convert this color 1 to this color 2, and if I need this pair, that this color to be matched with this color, I need to convert this 3 to the color 2 followed by, and it will cost me a 1 operation. So you can see total number of cost to find n by 2 matching pairs will be like 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Okay, now but one thing that I need to like recall, that you can easily see to recolor a sock to any color, that is suppose we have left sock as 1 and right sock as 2, to recolor a sock to any other color it will cost as 1 operation, that is cost equal to 1. We need to pay $1, and to convert a left sock into a right sock or vice versa we need to just also pay a $1. Okay, now there is one tricky point in this question. Suppose we have the orientation of left sock and right sock like that 1 1 and let's say we will have like okay, so we have like 1 3 let's say, and in the right sock we have the arrangement of colors like 2 and 2. Okay, so if we have this like left sock contains the color of socks like 1 and 3 and right sock contains the color of socks like 2 and 2, and we need to find the minimum cost to find the matching pairs. Okay, you can easily see I can just pay $1 and just transform one sock from this, you can see from this one, or you can also say from this two. So I can just transform, I can just send one sock from this right sock to this left sock. So I will have the pairs like in left sock like 1, 2, and 3. Since one right sock is transferred from this right sock, or you can say right sock, no, you can say right sock box, or you can see to this left sock box, and it should be like another sock is present like 2, and it is already costed me $1. Now you can see I have a matching pair like this 2 and 2, and this is going to be like eliminated. That is, I have already found one matching pair. Now you can see there is 1 and 3 is present in left sock, and the right sock doesn't contains any element. So if you want one more matching pair, I just need to transfer this 3 to this right sock. So it will contain like 1 and 3. Again, it will cost me $1. And you can see now still the values are not matching. I need to just transfer any one sock to any of the color that we want, but it will cost me one again $1. I can just also find n by 2 matching pairs with the cost equal to 3, but this cost is not going to be minimum. As I've already said, the minimum cost should be like 2. How it will be like 2? Convert all the colors in any of the socks to the any of the color that we want to find the matching pair. That is, convert 1 to 2, we convert 3 to also 2. Then we can easily see we'll find the matching pair 2 comma 2 and 2 comma 2. That is, every pair has an element which is present in left sock as well as in the right sock also. Okay, so let us try to understand this problem more with the help of one more example, and then we will find out the approach for this problem. Okay, so suppose we have been given this element, that is first 5 elements is going to denote the colors of the socks present in the like present colors of socks of left leg, you can also say left sock, and another last sock is going to denote for the right ones. Okay, so it should be like 6, 5, 4, 3 and 2. Okay, so I will like 3 and 2 is present for the left sock and 1 is going to be present for the right sock. Okay, and the numbers are going to basically denote the colors. You can easily see I will have to find the n by 2 matching pairs. If n is going to be like 6, I need to find 3 matching pairs. And you can easily see initially we will have no matching pair. All the numbers is going to be like distinct, and any number in this left sock is like pairwise distinct, and any number present in this left sock arrangement is not present in the right sock, so I cannot have a matching pair. Okay, so let's try to form the matching pair, 3 matching pairs. You can easily see for forming 3 matching pairs, at least I should have to contain 3 elements in the left sock arrangement and 3 elements in the right sock arrangement. You can see in the left sock I will have 5 elements currently now, and in this one I will have 3 elements in currently now. Okay, it means that I need to just transfer 2 elements from this one to this position. Okay, so let us transfer this 2 and this 3 to this one. Okay, so I will have like 2 and 3. So right sock contains 1, 2, and 3, and left sock contains 6, 5, and 4. You can see transferring from left sock to right sock or vice versa will always cost me one operation for one sock. Okay, so you can easily say I have already spent 2. That is cost equal to 2. That is, I have already spent $2. Okay, now you can easily see I will have to find the n by 2 matching pairs. Okay, all the elements are going to be distinct, and this one is also going to be like distinct. Converts the elements to any color, that is 6 to 1, 5 to 2, and 4 to 3. So you can see total minimum cost should be like 2 plus 3, and it should be like 5. Okay, and let us talk about this example now. Okay, you can see L is going to be like, now I will take L as 2. That is, first 2 elements is for the left sock, and next one like 2, 2, and it should be like 2 and 2. Okay, this is for right sock. You can see if we have been asked that what will the minimum cost to have three matching pairs. You can easily see initially I have no matching pairs. Okay, I will need to find out the at least like three matching pairs. Okay, you can easily see initially if one is going to be like here in this left sock, I will have no one present in this right sock. Okay, so let us find out the matching pairs. So the very best way to do such type of arrangements, for this type of arrangement, you can easily see I have two elements whose color is going to be like same. So the very best way is to transfer this one of the two to this one. Okay, so it should become like, I will just erase this two and I will place this two over there. You can see this is going to be like one of the matching pairs. And what is the cost of doing such operation? You can see one, because I have just used one transfer operation. Okay, I am just writing down over here, that is my cost is one, plus if I will have some more cost. Okay, now you can see I will have the arrangement like one and one and this two and two. Okay, I need to find two more matching pairs. Okay, so I will again transfer this like you can see I will have like these two and two. I will transfer one of the two to this left sock. Okay, if I will do that, I will have this two. And you can see I will have one of the matching pairs like this one. Okay, and again the cost should be incremented by one because I have used one transfer operation. And you can easily see I can do the, I will have two ones over there. Again I will transfer one of the ones to this right sock and my cost should be incremented by one and it would be like three. Okay, so this is the basically any dry run, or you can also say for this examples. Let me talk about the approach, the general approach that I am going to use to solve this problem in the best possible way. Okay, so let's try to understand. Okay, so what I am going to do is like, suppose we have an array like a0 a1 and it goes up to like a of n minus 1, and first l element starting from right is going to denote the colors present in this left sock, and then the followed by first r elements going to denote the colors present in this right sock arrangement. Okay, so what I am going to do is just increment the type of color. Let's say a0 is going to denote the color of like type 2. I will just increment the color of this type 2 by 1 in this left sock arrangement. Okay, so I will just write down one statement. You can easily understand there is will be a left vector, or you can say an array, and there will be color. Left would be like maximum initialized with like 10^5. You can easily see ci is going to like vary up to n is going to like vary up to 2 × 10^5. So I will assign, that is increment the color of this that is, let's say a0 will denote some color, left of this color a0 will be incremented by 1, and similarly for every left color present in the left sock, and there will be right also. Okay, I will increment the values for a particular color. Okay, now you can see if I will have some matching pairs already present in this arrangement, that is there is some color which is also present in this left sock and which is also present in this right sock. Okay, that is, let's say 2 and 2. Okay, that is this 2 is also present in this left sock arrangement and this 2 is also present in right sock arrangement. So you can easily see I have already found some of the matching pairs. So what I am going to do is just increment this value, that is left of I minus something equal to, let's say mn. Mn is going to denote the minimum of left of I and right of I. I am doing this for a every color, that is color starting from I equal to 1 to I equal to n. And the reason is, that is we have already found some matching pairs in my current arrangement. Okay, then what about like my current arrangement is going to denote the distinct values. That is, I am just talking about this case. That is, okay, let me denote, let me erase this one. Okay, now suppose that, okay, let me take explain this in a very short way. Like we have this 2 2 2. Okay, so I'm just writing down clearly 2 2 2 and 3 and 4, and we have this right sock arrangement like 2 4, like okay 2 5 6 7. Okay, if we just try to push the colors, like you can easily see this, I will have the frequency of this 2 as 3. Okay, frequency of 2 as 3 and frequency of 3 as 1 and frequency of 4 as 1. You can easily see this 2 is also present in this 2 and here frequency is 1. I will just decrement the number of matching pairs, that is minimum number of matching pairs is like minimum of this 1 and this 3. Okay, so I will decrement this frequency 3 by 1. that is minimum of 1 and 3, it would become 2, and here 2 frequency would become 0. Okay, after doing all such for every color of eye, you can easily see I will have some state like left sock will contains the sum of the elements which are, that is left sock will contains the elements which are already not present in this right sock, and vice versa. Okay, so let's say we will have some elements like 2 3 5 7, and in this right sock I will have the colors like 1, let's say 4, and let's say 6 and 8. Okay, we'll have, because I was just already subtracted the minimum value of the common colors. Okay, so now we will have some distinct colors. Okay, so let me just erase this one also, it will it may create confusions. Okay, so I will have the colors now. Now the main thing is suppose that size of this left sock, let's say equal to x, and this number of elements present in this right sock is also equal to x, and if L is going to be equal to R, what is the minimum number of cost that I need to spend to make the matching pairs? You can easily see the minimum cost should be like, if L is going to be equal to R, just convert every color, that is 2, 3, 5, 7, that is we can convert any color that is that we want. Okay, I will convert this 2 to 1 and 3 to 4, and my answer in case if L is exactly equal to R would be like L, that is size of any of the sock. Okay, and what about if some elements is not going to be like that is sizes of this left sock and this right sock is not going to be like equal. Okay, so let us talk about this case, like 2 3 5 7, and let's say I will have like 9, and let's say I will have 11, and this is the elements colors present in this left sock, and here I will have the colors like 1 and 4. You can easily see if I will have such type of arrangement, I have no matching pairs. Okay, so I will think in the case like I need to just find n by 2 matching pairs. Okay, so total number of elements is 8, I need to find 4 matching pairs. So first of all I will think to make the sizes of this left sock and right sock to be equal. Okay, so if I will try to make the sizes of this left sock and right sock to be equal, you can easily see the size should be like 4 and 4. Just I need to just bring 2 elements from this left sock to this right sock. Okay, so what about the maximum answer that I should have to care for that? Okay, so you can easily see if I need to bring this 2 socks from left sock to this right sock, my cost would be incremented by this 2, and I will have the elements like, suppose I will push 11 and 9. Now I will have to just you can easily see I will have to just transfer these 2 cost, or you can easily see I will have to just transfer all these colors to the colors that is present in this alternate sock, that is the right sock. So my answer in maximum case would be like, let me write down one thing, like what is the number of transfers that I need to do, transfers. Okay, my number of case would be, answer would be incremented by transfers plus, and you can easily see my value should be like incremented by 2 things, that is twice of transfer, that is I just in multiply in the factor by 2, because you can see those elements that is going to be transferred must be exactly equal to that, if I need to find the matching pairs must be exactly equal to the number of elements, or you can see the type of element present in this left sock also. So I will just increment the transfer by into 2, that is multiplied by 2, so that I will have the cost, like if I will transfer 11 to this one, it will cost me 1. Now I try to want to make 7 equal to 11, so I need to spend 1 more cost. Okay, so my cost should be like twice of transfers plus, you can easily see I will have to do one more thing, that is minimum of this value, that is you can easily see initially I will have the elements like only 1 and 4, and the transfer is for only 2 elements. So I need to just make these two elements equal, that is which is actually minimum of already present size of the sock, that is minimum of L and R. Okay, so my answer should be initialized with twice of transfer plus minimum of L and R. Okay, so can this be the minimum value that I need to find it out? No, this is not going to be like minimum value. Then what should be the minimum value? We need to decrement something, and what we need to decrement something, let's try to understand. Okay, so just I was talking about, suppose in this case I have just taken a like simple example, suppose we have the element like this. We will have some more elements like here 2, one more 2 will be present, and here one more 9 would be present. You can easily see if I will have some color that is present in any of the sock and whose frequency is like greater than 1, you can easily see the optimal choice will be like just transfer this one to another sock. And if I will transfer this one to another sock, I will have like this two will be transferred and this two. And again, you can see I will find a matching pair in only one cost. And this is going to be optimal. So the only thing that you need to do is initially our answer would be like twice of the transfer that I need to done to make the socks at equal level. Okay, so twice of transfer, and this is the cost plus the minimum of initial levels, that is size of the socks L and R. Okay, so I need to decrement the answer for every, that is you can see just I have just taken, if you have the elements like 2 and 2, and I need to just transfer one element from any of the socks to the other socks, and it will make a matching pair. So whenever we will find some socks whose frequency, that is in some sock whose color of frequency is like greater than 1, I will just decrement my answer by 1, and also I will decrement that color value by 2, okay, and my transfer would decrease by 1. And if you are not going to understand this, no need to worry about, this is going to be like best choice for just distributing the color of the socks. And let us try to understand this more in the coding part. Okay, so let us move further. So you can see what I have done is just taken the left one and this right one. Okay, I will just zoom it out first. And just I have pushed the frequency of this color in left sock and right sock. Okay, so just I have first done for this first L like inputs is for the left sock, and this followed by first R input for this right sock. And you can easily see if there is some matching pair already present, I will just decrement that value. Okay, that is left of I minus equal to minimum of, and MN is going to be like minimum of left of I and right of I. There are minimum of left of I comma right of I pairs, okay, for a particular color. I just decremented that value. Now you can see I've just modified this value of L. L is going to denote the sum of all the socks currently now present in this left one, and R is going to denote the sum of all the socks present in this right one, that is the right sock. If L is going to be like R, just convert every color in this left sock to this right sock, that should be the minimum value. And I will just print the L, so just make the matching pairs as far as possible. And now what I've done is just to try to make this L to store the minimum size, and correspondingly this left one also. If L is going to be like greater than R, strictly greater, just swap this LR and swap this left and right. Just I've done for calculation convenience. Okay, so what is my transfer that I need to do to make both the sizes of the socks to be equal? Since we have to make the M by 2 matching pairs, first I need to make the sizes of the socks to be equal, and the transfer that I need to do would be like R minus L upon 2. And what is the cost associated with this transfer? Since the every element that is present in this left sock is not present in this right sock, the cost associated would be like twice of this transfer plus L. You can see L is going to be like less than R. L is going to be strictly less than R. So minimum of this L and R would be like L. So my cost would be like twice of transfer plus L. And what I am going to do, just for every I up to N, just check it out. If transfer is positive, that is still the levels are not equal. And this right of I, you can easily see, I am just now working on this right of I. Since L is going to be like less than R, R has like more number of socks. So I will work upon this right of I, and this right of I is greater than 1, that is there exists a color whose frequency is greater than 1, just like this one, that is I will have like this 2 and 2. I will transfer this 2 to another sock, and it will cost me 1. There, since I have already counted 1 extra answers, I will just decrement my transfer and decrement my 1 answer, and right of I would be decremented by 2 as obvious. Then finally I will print the answer after doing this for every colors. Okay. So this is going to be given accepted code. So if you have any doubts, do not forget to mention in the comment section of the video. And I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and do subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.